are the tribunals and commissions orders. We covered DRT orders, NCLT. SEBI, trademark orders. So these are the tribunals and commissions orders. Apart from this, we are also covering international database like Australia, Bangladesh, Canada, Hong Kong, International Court of Justice for the European Communities, New Zealand, Pakistan, Singapore, South Africa, Sri Lanka. We have recently added the English reports from 1220 to 1873 and maritime cases from 1870 to 1940. Now we will start with the my preferences, that is available under the profile my preferences. So you can set default preferences for your customized search views. For example, if you want a result sort by the relevancy, or if you want the newest judgment first when you search from Manu Search or Legal Search, then you can sort the results by decision date newest. You can make it default. You can also enable dictionary link for the Supreme Court judgments. We have enabled dictionary link. It will give you the definition of popular words in document. You can also default set for the synonym preferences. For example, if you are searching for particular word like a murder, then it will also search for a section 302 IPC and the synonyms words. Under the navigator preferences, you can also select or deselect the different code. If you don't require department, if you don't require industry, then you can uncheck that particular thing. And if you want publisher wise filtration, then you select the publisher. So it will come under the default preferences. Now the second one is like, we can see the present law with the date of inceptions. For example, the Companies Act. You can see the act-wise comparativity chart under this. You can select the Companies Act 2013 and click on the Go button. Then it will give you the chart and it will give you the Companies Act 1956, which are the sections, and Companies Act 2013, which are the new sections with the old sections. So you can compare. For example, section 2.5 of old act for banking company, now it will be section 2.9. Same thing, you can see the different sections. Now we will take the taxonomy option. For example, under the table of content, you can see the legal taxonomy. Basically, taxonomy is giving you the subject and the sub-subject. For example, if you are looking for a Constitution of India, then you can see the different topics of Constitution India. For example, we want to see fundamental rights, then it will give you the sub-subject of that particular topic. Now we want to identify the selected judgments on that. So when we click on the plus sign, it will give you the subject, subtopics of that particular subject. And when we click on this link, it will give you the judgment of that particular topic. You can also filter from here. If you have an additional sections, then you can filter from the section. You can also open the judgment from here. These are the judgments on right to education. Now we'll take another subject. For example, Hindu law of marriage. Now we want matrimonial suits. Then we want judgments on divorce. So you can see these are the judgments on that particular subject. You can check from here, like where that particular case has been referred in other cases. You can open the judgment by clicking on the Manupatra citation. Now we will take the integrated of citation analysis. So basically, this is a citation search. Now we will take the integrated citation analysis. For example, we'll start with the citation search. It will be on the top next to legal search. You can search for a different citations. We are covering around 314 journals across India. This is for the Indian citation. Now we want to search for a AIR 2009 Supreme Court 1059. Then we have to select the AIR Supreme Court and the year 2009. The two fields are compulsory. You have to input. Then you can give the page number, for example, 1059. So when we click on the search, it will directly search for that particular citation. To open the case, you can click on this link or a Manupatra citation. So like that, you can open that particular citation. You can see the equivalent citation under the Manupatra citation. Now, for example, if we search for any particular keyword, then we can use the Manu search. Under that, you can see this particular link that is called a Manu Instant. When we click on that link, it will give you the party's name, citation, date of the decision, on which subject that particular judgment, which are the acts used in this judgment, then case note, the crux of the judgment. You can also see the citing reference. In this judgment, there are seven judgments referred, which are called a mention. This is the Manu Instant. Now we want to see all Manu Instant for that particular 10 judgments. We can click on this link, see all Manu Instant. So it will give you the 10 judgments in a one document. You can also take a printout. If you are using Chrome, you can save as a PDF also. Now we can filter the results, for example, a cited most. So we can filter all the judgments with the keyword is winding up. Now we can identify the landmark judgments which are more referred in other cases or which are more cited in other cases. For example, Ramana, National Insurance. We can also see the this flag. It will give you the case overruled. For example, Keshwananda Bharti. Now we open any judgment. For example, Indira Sonai judgment we will open. So we'll go on the top. Next to Manupatra citation, you can see this particular setting button that is called a Manu cite. So it will give you the treatment of this particular case. So how many times that particular case has been referred in other cases after the decision of 1992. So last cited on 4th March 2020. You can also see like what are the citing reference given in other cases. For example, this particular case has been discussed in 53% judgments out of 816. 32% judgments are like mentioned, 12% relied on, 2% distinguished, 1% is dissented, and still it's not affirmed. Another way to find out the Manu site is on a top. You can see below to assisted search. When we click on this link, Manu site, it will give you all the judgments which are referred in this particular judgment. And also you can see treatment of that particular judgment. When we click on this link, it will give you the treatment in other cases. So these are the cases which are referred in this judgment. So these are the cases referred, and you can see the treatment directly from here. We can also click on this link and we can see the treatment of that particular case through Manu site. Now the next one is like cited in para. So we can identify the cases where that particular has been referred. So we can see the list of the cases, but when we click on the plus sign, it will give you the exact paragraph where that particular case has been referred. When we click on the plus sign, it will give you the exact paragraph where that particular case has been referred. So you can identify on which point of law the discussion is going on in this particular paragraph. For example, we'll take Airport Authority of India. In the paragraph number 25, you can see they have taken a paragraph number 9 of Indra Sonai. So you can see which paragraph they have referred and what are the discussion going on, what are the point of law discussed in this particular judgment, the recent case. You can also see the cited, if any judgment referred in other cases, you can directly see cited one time. Now we can see this particular case. This case has been referred one time. So when we go to that particular judgment, when we click on the Manu citation, it will open that particular case. Now, how we create a folder? Now, you want to store that particular case by creating a folder. This is the judgment on constitution. Now click on this particular link, you can save this document in Manu Patra. Click on this link, it will create a new folder. You have to give name. You can create a subfolder also. For example, constitution. You can also set a password. Click on the create. Now you can select that particular folder and click on the save button. So it will, this particular judgment, Indra judgment, will save in the this folder. Now we want to browse that particular folder. For that, we can, under the legal search, you can see the my save document. Just click on that link, it will open your folder list. We can select that particular folder. When we click on this link, it will open in the right side those judgments which you have saved. Now I'll use one for example. Want to open this particular case, SBP versus Patel Engineering. Now I want to identify which are the paragraph of SBP and company versus Patel Engineering referred in Supreme Court judgments and how many times that particular paragraph referred. For if paragraph referred more number of times, it may like you can say it's an important paragraph also. So for that, we have created tool, an important paragraph. For that, just click on the M para, the icon. You can see icon from here. This is the important paragraph. When we click on this link, it will open in a separate window. Now, when we click under the case map, you can see this. These are the paragraph and the number is showing how many times that particular paragraph has been cited or quoted in Supreme Court cases. For example, when you click the link, it will give you the paragraph of SBP versus Patel Engineering. Now, when we click on this judgment, it will give you where that particular paragraph quoted. The same way, you can also click on the another judgment. This paragraph referred in, quoted in Anil Kumar also. Now, this is the another paragraph, particular paragraph referred to this Supreme Court judgment. So you can identify how many times that particular paragraph has been quoted or referred in other cases through important paragraph. Now you have to create a notes. You have heard about the sticky notes on Manupatra. So how it will useful to use in the judgments? Nowadays, like in a lockdown, you maybe refer some cases. For that, you want to create an index, which are the paragraph is useful in your case. For that, we have a one idea that you can utilize that thing for your client wise or a topic wise also. When we click on this link, you just click on this link, it will enable the sticky note. Now, I can understand the paragraph number 4 is relevant for a particular file which I am referring right now for a ABC or XYZ. So I just click on the highlight that particular paragraph. We can click add highlight. Then I'll select this particular paragraph. So now it's get highlighted. Now we want to add the comments why that particular paragraph is very useful in your case. For that, we can create the add the comments, just single click and then just click in the bottom of the paragraph or wherever you required. Now click a right click. You can now add the topic also, or you can add your client name. For example, this is related to ABC company and on ABC versus R, for example. Just I have saved that particular name. Now I'll go to the, just scroll down to ABC versus R. Now I can give a title, like on which topic, on which point of law it's discussing is going on in this particular paragraph. For example, it's related to arbitration agreement. Under this particular box, you can give your comments, like how it will be useful, this particular paragraph, in your ABC versus R case. Nowadays, like when you go to the court and when you open that particular index, it will remember, it will give you the detail, like why you have highlighted that particular paragraph. For example, I'll just write down para information, for example, and I just save this particular paragraph. Now I'll save this particular judgment also under my particular case. For example, it's related to this particular folder. I just save file. Now its particular judgment has been saved. Now when we click on this sticky note summary, you can see your client name ABC versus R. So now you can see only those particular paragraph which you have highlighted, and with the party's name, appellant versus respondent, on which topic you have highlighted that particular paragraph. And you can also see your content of that for that particular paragraph under the para information. Now I want to add more cases for that particular client. So again, I'll go to some another judgment. For example, this particular judgment referred in this judgment. Now I want to highlight the paragraph of this particular judgment. This particular case has been overruled also by the SPP versus Patel Engineering. You can see on the judgment. Now when we click on this link, again I'll highlight the paragraph. Just select the paragraph which is relevant to for your particular case. For example, I'll just highlight paragraph number 11 and I'll add the comment also. Now I'll select again my client name ABC versus R, and now I want to put, for example, this is again on arbitral award. And I'll give my information why this particular paragraph is used for this particular case. I just save this particular information. Again, I'll save this sticky note in my folder. I'll go to the sticky note summary. Now I have two cases. One is SBP versus Patel Engineering, and another one is Konkan Railway versus Rani Construction, which are overruled by the SBP and Patel. But the paragraph number 11 is useful in some point of law on the arbitral award. So you can add your comments also. So you can generate this particular list. You can mail this particular list to your senior or to your anyone. You can also store this particular index by downloading the PDF. You can open this particular PDF. Now you can see the ABC versus R is there. These are the paragraph which you have highlighted. You can also take a printout and put an index on your file, in your file. Now, how can we create a notes on that particular judgment? For example, I want to create a note on this particular judgment. For example, Nelly Bharat Engineering Company versus State of Bihar. For that, I have to create, for that I have to search first this particular case. I can filter from here, a Supreme Court. Now I'll open this particular judgment in a same body. Now I'll go to the my notepad and I can create the notes. We can say the notes on the judgment, key points of the judgment that you can share with your Manupatra clients also. And also you can take a printout and you can send by a mail also. You can take a printout or send by mail. Now I want to add notes on that particular thing. Just click on the add to my notepad. You can give a title. It's related to industrial dispute. For example, section 25. And the key points you can also copy from these particular judgment, or you can add your comments. I'll just click on the submit button. Now we can see this particular icon on a home page, that is a view note. So whatever you create on the judgment, you can see your colleague also, if you are using the same login ID password, or then your colleague also can see. So he can save his time. What are the key points of this particular judgment from the judgments, or what are the comments? It is related to some particular case. You can refer that particular, you can give the name under this particular notepad. So all the tools like will save your time. Basic thing is like you can save your time and you can use the all the features. Now I want to search for an international citation also. So here we have a list. You can select the publishers. These are the publishers we have for the international. For example, All England Law Reports, you can specify the year. You can select the year. You can click on the search. Or you can select the different publisher. You can see the journal title from here. These are the journal titles. These are the titles we are covering. Apart from this particular search, we are also covering the, now we will again come with the database, on the database, because in the beginning, like my screen was not like properly visible to everyone. So I'll start with the database again. So this is Supreme Court judgments. You can click on the plus link. It will expand. You can see it from 1950 we are covering. For the high courts, we're covering from 1860. Apart from Supreme Court and High Court judgments, we are covering tribunals and commissions orders. Under the international database, we are covering Court of Justice of the European Communities, International Court of Justice, the English reports from 1220 to 1873. Recently, we have added this particular maritime cases from 1870 to 1940. Under the business and policy, you can see the subject wise information. For example, I want to see related to arbitration. Now we can see all the information like from the introduction to the treaties. We can see the background also, Indian arbitration and international arbitration, which are the acts used in for that particular subject, which are the state rules for that particular subject. We can see the ordinance of that for that particular subject, schemes, reports, forms, model arbitration agreement. And for the international arbitration also, you can see the other things. Same way, we are also providing subject wise information for capital market, competition law, consumer law, corporate law, cyber law and IT laws, employment laws, forex banking is there, insolvency is there, insurance. These are the international law, public and private international law. You can say the this way you can open that particular thing. Then media and communications, mines and minerals, power energy. For example, we'll start with the corporate law, which are the acts used, rules, state acts, forms, company law procedures are there, direction and guidelines are there, schemes, circulars and notification for that particular subject, due date and penalties, resolutions, मंथ वाइज कंप्लायंस स्केड्यूल फॉर कंपनीज, कमिटी रिपोर्ट्स, एलएलपी डिटेल्स, अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड, सेक्रेटरियल स्टैंडर्ड्स आर देयर, ऑडिटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स एंड द अनदर सब्जेक्ट इज कॉर्पोरेट लॉ एंड टैक्सेशन, द सेम इट्स पार्ट ऑफ बिजनेस एंड पॉलिसी. यू कैन सी द डायरेक्ट टैक्सेशन, इनडायरेक्ट टैक्सेशन, जीएसटी एंड वैट. We have a notification. We have notification circulars for central and state. We can see a notification circulars for department wise. You can see circulars from 2020 onwards. You can see all the departments are there. For example, we want to see the SEBI regulation. You can click on this plus sign, it will expand the domain. When we click on the table of content, it will give you the list of the regulations for 2020. The same way, you can also browse the notification circulars start from 2008 to 2019 from the next domain. You can also see the ministry wise, department wise list. The same way we are providing for the state also. Now under BARE Act, you can see the Central Act and the local acts. For example, when you click on the plus sign, it will open the table of content. You can see Central Acts alphabetically, subject wise, ministry wise and industry wise. Also, you can see the repeal acts, the chronological wise, like which are the new acts introduced in 2020. You can see those acts in 2020. Now I want acts for a FMCG industry. So I just select the industry wise and click on the FMCG. So it will give me the list of the acts for the FMCG industry. Now I want to identify particular case on particular subject of electricity. So we can identify subject also. The same way we can identify by alphabetically. So what are the other icons in the act? For example, we'll take the Aadhaar Act 2016. You can see this particular act in a different language. For example, a Hindi, you can download in a Hindi also. You can see the brief facts, statement of objective, date of assent, then amendments, which are the amendments act. You can also see the rules directly from here for that particular act. When we click on this link, it will open the rules, regulations and orders. This is the annotations, notes on that particular section wise notes. You can see by that particular section bring here, what is the utility of that particular section. So you can see the notes. Sometimes we want that particular act, we want to download that particular act, we want to read offline, so we can open that particular act in a single window. When we click on this blue icon, it will open act in a single window. You can see all the sections in a continuously. You can directly copy that particular section from here and paste to your draft also. The next button will, like some acts like very huge acts, so we have divided into some different sections. So when we click on the next, it will give you the other sections also of that particular act. So to download in a PDF, if you are using Chrome, you can click on the print, you can save as a PDF. That wise you can save as a offline also. When we click on the next, it will save this particular sections in a part two. So we have divided into two parts. So you can download BareActs also. The same way you can see the rules. Sorry, one more thing I want to show, like for example, in 2019, you can see the flag. So it is like, it means like this particular act date of enforcement not notified yet. So you can see the flag mark on the new acts, for example, Consumer Protection Act. These are the flag marks showing yet to be enforced. We can also see the rules. When we click on the rules, it will give you the right side. You can see the act title and the rules for that particular act. Also, you can find and identify the regulations. Orders, schemes, for example, directions and guidelines. These are the directions and guidelines. When we click on the state, it will give you the list of the all the state. For example, when we click on the Delhi, it will give you the statutes of for that particular state. When we click on the table of content, these are the acts, and when we click on the plus sign, it will give you the rules. The same way we can search for other states also, Kerala, Karnataka, Gujarat, Bihar, Andhra Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Northeast, Orissa. These are the acts for the state. We also cover committee reports. It will be available under the bills, draft, ordinance. You can see the assembly debates, law commission report, and other subject wise reports. We can see the court fees directly from here, court fees for different state. Court forms are there, sample court forms. This we have started recently. Can see the court forms. For example, if you are going to Delhi and if you want to file write an application for certified copy, just click on this link. It will give you the sample application. Just download, take a printout, and you can directly file. Under the court rules, you can see court rules. We have a sample drafts, agreement and deeds. These are the subject wise drafts, agreements. For example, this is the agreement for a family agreement. For example, arbitration. These are the arbitrations. Notice to arbitrator, notice of appointment of arbitrator. So these are the sample drafts you can see. Just open that particular draft. You can download in a PDF. We are also providing the pending bills. So bills in Parliament, ordinance. So these are the pending bills. You can see objective and purpose, bill number, where that particular on which date it's like introduced in the house. And when it passed by the Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha and Rajya Sabha, what is the ascent date, enforcement date or act number you can see. You can also see in a Hindi also. And these are three links, like as introduced in Lok Sabha, like after passed by the Lok Sabha, you can see the link, passed by the Lok Sabha, passed by the both the houses, you can see the main act text. Also, you can see this particular act under the Central Act section also. Same way, we are also providing stamp duty. You can directly select the stamp duty for different state. Suit violation is there. Under the forms, these are the statutory forms with the rules and regulations. The rules, you can see some forms are there. So we have divided into subject wise. For example, insolvency, these are the rules for that particular, sorry, forms. Same way, under the miscellaneous, you can see the budget, economy surveys, circle rates, national cases in news, international cases in news. These are the national cases in news. Under the e-books, you can see e-books, handbook on real estate investment, and the academic e-book subject wise are there. Also, you can see articles. You can see a category wise article by students, article by professional, academic journals are there, newsletter from different law firms are there, case studies and brief moot memorials are there, press release, insights. For example, when we click on this link, it will give you the articles. You can filter by the publication, year of publication, for example, 2020. You can see the subject is insolvency, article by student. Student name, author name. The same way you can filter by the article by the professionals. So same way you can also write articles and you can send it to Manupatra by mail to articles@manupatra.com. If you have any question, you can ask me. Yes, Parth. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, Parth.
Are you able to hear me?
Yes.
Actually, I wanted to ask this question yesterday, but they didn't allow due to lack
Okay.
of time. As you might be aware, like I'm from IIT
Okay.
Kharagpur Law School. So we have a subscription for SSC Online as well as Manupatra. But what
Okay.
happens is, due to lack of time, sometimes we don't have time to go through the whole judgment. So we
Yes.
mostly, for research purpose, prefer Manupatra. But
Okay.
SSC Online has a what do you call facility where we can see the digest point.
Okay.
Let's say I have to refer Keshavanandan Bharti judgment. So in that case, they have a facility for providing digest point whereby we can say we can see what are the law points which are held in that particular judgment, right?
Now, in the judgments.
So, is there any facility like that in Manupatra as well that I wanted to know? Because sometimes we don't have time to go through the whole judgment, but we want to know what are the law points which are held by judges in that judgment. Yeah.
In our like webinar, like we I have shown the M-Para then cited in para. It will give you the brief information of that particular judgment, like whether that particular case. Also, you can see under the authority check also. The in your previous session, if you have like gone through it, there is a green button that will give you the information like Keshavananda Bharti in referred in, for example, 800 judgments. So out of 800, like you can identify those judgment where that particular case has been relied on. So you can see all the cases of that particular C. Well, you
Yes,
can
that
see
is there.
cited in
Yeah.
para and the M para. Cited in para is like very useful. Like you can just click on the plus sign. It will give you the exact paragraph where that particular case has been referred and on which point it has been discussed.
Okay. And one
Okay.
another question.
Yeah.
You have another website for Case Watch.
Yeah.
So for our law school, we have a IP login, means IP based login. So
Okay.
is it applicable in Case Watch as well? Because I tried, but I couldn't. So
No, case watch is like if you have any case which is pending in Supreme Court or any
it's mostly for practicing advocates, is
yeah,
it?
it will be for the practicing advocates. And
Okay.
if you want a trial, you can register as a trial also. You can
Okay.
write a contact at manupatra.com if you want to detail.
Okay.
Right, Parth?
Okay.
Yes, Pradiman. Hello.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah, now I can hear you.
Achha, I wanted to know ki when you go by find judgments by section, so we have this search and result in Manupatra, right? So do we have something like that in this case by section also, like that field, like for example, if I want
You want to search for an Industrial Dispute Act Section 25, judgments
okay,
on Section 25 of Industrial Dispute Act, right?
right.
You can search by three way. You can go to the legal search and you can select
Right,
the
right, right, right. I understood
advice.
that point. What I'm trying to say is like when you do Section 25 वाला सर्च तो
Okay,
उसमें
okay.
सब कुछ आ जाता है. सो एंड नाउ आई वांट टू
Refine.
सर्च रिफाइन इट. या एग्जैक्टली, आई वांट टू रिफाइन इट. सो इज देयर ऑप्शन ऑफ रिफाइन आल्सो?
Refine with the another section.
यस.
Okay. For that, you can use two things. Like there is a like next to search, you can identify the bulb sign. It will give you the search tips. Under that search tips, you can see the unordered proximity search or order and the order proximity search. For example, if you have searched for Industrial Dispute Section 25, now you want to with Negotiable Instrument Act Section 138. So you can use in a double quote Negotiable Instrument Section 130. And in the last, you just close the double quotes and put a sign at the rate 7. So you can identify those judgment which are with the negotiable instrument section 138. So what
Okay.
it will work, like it will do, like it will search all the four words in the given order. Right?
Okay. So, all right. ठीक,
And
थैंक
if you place a slash sign instead of at the rate,
यू.
you can search four words in any order. So if any judgment, if any text like Section 138 of Negotiable Instrument Act, ऐसा कुछ लिखा होगा तो वो भी आ जाएगा. And it will also come Negotiable Instrument Section 138. So just go to the search tips and use unordered proximity and proximity search. Order-wise proximity search. So it will clear it.
Okay.
And if you have any issue, you can write a mail to contact at manupatra.com. I'll give you reply on that.
All right, that'll be great. Thank you.
Okay. if anyone is having any question, you can directly write to email address contact@manupatra.com. Some connectivity issue may be